This is an introduction to using Google Scholar, a source to search for journal articles, cases and book citations conveniently in one place from across the web. Before we start, I just want to point out some limitations that you should be aware of when using Google Scholar. Unlike other library resources that you have access to as a student at Kent, there are not as many choices in terms of filtering your search results. Whilst it does search academic content, there is no filter for easily identifying peer-reviewed content, which is important for sourcing academic, credible articles which have been validated by experts in the subject area. It also doesn't use subject headings, which can help to identify standard terms for particular themes and topics that you may not have already considered. Bearing these limitations in mind, Google Scholar can be a convenient interface to start searching for academic content before then going on to explore other resources that you have access to as a student at Kent. Before we start searching, I'm just going to point out an area on Google Scholar where you can set your preferences to show that you are a student at Kent and give you access to the full text articles that we subscribe to. So in the top left of the screen, you'll see the three lines, which is known as a hamburger menu. If you click on here, and you can scroll down to the area that says settings. From the settings link, you need to click on the area that says library links. Here, all you need to do is type in your home institution. So just start to type in University of Kent and then search. You'll see you get a number of selections back and you just need to make sure that you've chosen the University of Kent one. Save your settings. What this will then allow you to do is once you carry out a search, so I'm just going to choose communication skills, when the results come back, any articles that we have access to through our paid subscription databases, you will see a link just to the side of the entry. Clicking on here should then take you through to the University of Kent link, and you've got options to choose in terms of which one you want to link to. In terms of the search results themselves, you'll see there that you get information that you can click on in terms of the title and it will give you more of an abstract, more information about that. There are some basic filters just down to the left there in terms of date ranges. At the moment, it's sorted my results by relevance of the keywords, but I could change that to sort it by date if I wanted to see more recent results at the top. You will, of course, want to put more filters onto this search, though, to make it a little bit more specific. So if we go back to the hamburger menu and then scroll down to the advanced search option. So it's entered the communication skills into the first search box and then you've got a range of other search boxes that you can enter further terms to make it a little bit more specific. Exact phrase will search for keywords next to each other. So if you were looking for some terms that you needed to come back as a phrase or a sentence, that would be the search box to use. With at least one of the words, searches for two sets of keywords, but within the same article or the same reference. With at least one of the words, we'll search for either or. This is often used when you've got more than one term that can describe the same thing. Without the words is a not search. So that would be if you wanted to exclude a certain element from your search results. It then goes on to talk about some other areas where, for example, you can put in particular authors or a particular publication that you want it to search within. For this search, I'm just going to use an and search. So I'm going to go with at least one of the words and I'm going to include in there intercultural and then run my search again. And you can see now that the results have changed. As before, you will have the University of Kent link just to the side to link through to the full text. And you will be able to scroll through and find more information out about those particular topic areas. The other area that I wanted to go on and point out is around cited. So under each of the entries, you will see there's a little link that says cited by and then a number. This indicates that the particular article has been cited by other authors, either in their papers or in their reference list. This can be a useful tool to find other articles on a similar topic area or particular authors that write a lot in that particular area. So to access it, all you need to do is just simply click on the link, and then that will then expand to show you all of the articles that have referenced the original paper. You can then, of course, go into each of those and then again do the same and see how many articles have been referenced back to this paper. So it's a really good way of building up a wider sort of in-depth area of research. You can find more papers and find kind of more information about the topic area. So a really useful tool to be aware of. So that's it for using Google Scholar. Thank you for listening, and please don't forget to go on and have a look at some of the other resources within this site, particularly search strategies and some of the other library databases that are useful for you to know how to use.